Imagination Studio presents SpongeBob SquarePants, Chapter Book 1, Tea at the Treedome, by Terry Collins, based on the original teleplay by Peter Burns, Mr. Lawrence, and Paul Tibbett. Read for you by Mr. Lawrence. Chapter 1. Welcome to the sea. Beautiful, mysterious, and wet. It is here where the dolphin frolics and the electric eel slithers, where the shy octopus plays and the seahorse rides. But go farther down, all the way to the bottom of the ocean. Here is a world entirely different from what we know on dry land. A strange world with different rules, funny customs, and unusual creatures. Wow, four stingers! A squeaky voice exclaimed as an angry jellyfish buzzed by. Buzz away, jellyfish! The yellow box-shaped character continued in his best dramatic voice. For soon you shall belong to SpongeBob SquarePants. SpongeBob gave a few practice swings with his net in preparation to capture his prey. Then he readied himself as the jellyfish came around for another pass. Bzzz, said the jellyfish. SpongeBob buzzed back in his best jellyfish impersonation to lure him into his trap. Steady, he whispered, readying his net. Steady. The jellyfish slowed down and hovered over a blue sea anemone. Yes, SpongeBob screeched, bounding out of hiding and bringing down his net. The jellyfish avoided the attack and swam to the left. SpongeBob followed suit, swinging the net in a sideways arc, but somehow caught himself instead. Hanging in his own net, SpongeBob watched sadly as the jellyfish zipped home to jellyfish fields. Disappointed, SpongeBob continued to look for other jellyfish, but none were to be found. However, he did notice a funny-looking creature in a spacesuit wrestling a giant clam. SpongeBob did a double take. Spacesuit? Could it be space aliens? He wiggled out of his net and ran toward the scene. Upon closer inspection, SpongeBob saw that the spacesuit was actually a white, high-tech diving suit. As for the clam, well, it was huge and mean. The spry fighter growled like a grizzly bear and used a combination of judo and karate, plus some moves SpongeBob had never even seen before, to fight the threatening clam. The creature in a space helmet gave a final cry of triumph and conked the gray shell of the giant clam. It was this move that allowed SpongeBob to clearly see the fighter's face for the first time. Where have I seen this before? SpongeBob wondered. Reaching into his pocket, he took out his handy Barks Jr. field guide. SpongeBob frantically flipped through the pages. Aha! He cried, finding a page with a picture of the being in the diving suit. However, in the field guide, a furry head was exposed. Land squirrel, SpongeBob read aloud. She's a land squirrel, whatever that is. Suddenly, the squirrel gave out a loud grunt of surprise as the clam bit her leg. That little squirrel is in trouble, SpongeBob announced. This looks like a job for SpongeBob. Chapter 2. SpongeBob hiked up his square pants and raced to the land squirrel's rescue. As he ran down the hill, he saw the squirrel jerk her leg free. Gaining the upper paw, she began battering the clam like a loose penny in a supercharged washing machine. Take that, and this, and a mouth of that, the squirrel cried in a strong Texas accent as she socked and stomped. The clam rocked back and forth, weakening from the attack. SpongeBob was fascinated. He'd never seen anyone like this squirrel person. Y'all need to learn some manners, the squirrel snorted as she picked up her enemy and held it above her head. SpongeBob closed his eyes in fear. The clam was 10 times bigger than the little land squirrel. If she dropped it, she'd be squished like a bug. SpongeBob opened his eyes just in time to see the feisty squirrel body slam the battered clam into the sand face first. There, she said. Mean old clam. You know, you're about as ugly as homemade soup. Hooray, land squirrel! SpongeBob cheered. He was amazed at what he had seen. He had to befriend this brave warrior. Just then, SpongeBob saw the giant clam wiggle like a worm on a hook, trying to pull itself from the silt and muck on the ocean floor. "Look out!" SpongeBob yelled, but his warning was too late. The monster clam was free and was heading for the land squirrel. The clam soared through the air and tumbled toward the unsuspecting squirrel. She never knew what hit her as the clam's maw snapped shut like a bear trap, trapping her inside. "Hold on, little squirrel!" SpongeBob yelled, his scrawny legs a blur as he raced to his new companion's rescue. To fight this foe, SpongeBob would need to call on the discipline of karate. He struck a pose, one skinny arm crooked into the shape of a striking cobra.
"Yah-ha-hoi!"
he shouted, using the battle cries of a karate master. "You have fought well, giant clam," said SpongeBob, honoring his opponent. "Prepare to be vanquished!" First, he hopped onto his oversized enemy. Then, reaching down with both hands, SpongeBob gripped the stiff upper lip of the oversized clam and pulled with all of his might. SpongeBob gritted his teeth and gave a final Herculean effort, an effort so great, the snap of his square pants popped off. SpongeBob grunted. And then, the mouth of the mammoth clam began to inch open with a creaking sound. SpongeBob was so amazed he nearly let go. "Hey!" he said in disbelief. "I'm actually doing it!" What SpongeBob could not see was the land squirrel pushing the giant clam's jaws open from inside.
"Yah!"
the squirrel snarled from behind the glass of her helmet as she struggled to free herself.
"Yah, yah, yah!"
As the clam bucked like an angry bull, SpongeBob was tossed into the air. The squirrel hopped out of the clam's mouth and landed on her feet, ready for more action. But before she could make a move, SpongeBob re-entered the fray.
"Your shell is mine!"
he said determinedly as he grabbed the giant's muscular tongue. The squirrel gaped in surprise right before the clam's mouth slammed shut, trapping the heroic SpongeBob inside. Chapter 3.
"Hold on there, little square dude!" the squirrel cried. "I'm a-coming!"
She flipped the clam up like she was tossing a coin. When it landed, the fighting squirrel then moved on to some of her expert karate moves.
"Yah!"
she cried, unleashing a karate chop.
"Ha!"
she added, uncoiling a karate kick.
"Yah-ha!"
she finished, unspooling a series of master moves, making the clam spin like a top. The clam's mouth fell open, and a dazed and confused SpongeBob staggered out.
"What happened?"
SpongeBob asked, dizzy from his wild ride inside the mollusk. The squirrel stomped on the edge of the clam's lip with her boot, and it stood up on one end. She then proceeded to spin the shelled creature like a top, punching and jabbing at a rapid pace before delivering a final uppercut that sent the clam sailing up, up, and far away toward the forbidden lands of jellyfish fields.
"Howdy,"
the squirrel said, looking down at SpongeBob.
"Hey,"
SpongeBob said brightly.
"You like karate too?"
The squirrel obliged by assuming the pose of the swooping crane.
"Awesome. So what's your name?"
SpongeBob asked.
"Sandy,"
she said.
"Sandy Cheeks."
Sandy leaped up and went through a series of karate fighting stances.
"What do y'all call yourself?"
she asked as she moved across the ocean floor. SpongeBob grinned and ran toward a curved wall.
"I'm SpongeBob!"
he yelled as he ran up the wall, executed a perfect backflip, and landed at a 45-degree angle on the corner of his head directly in front of Sandy.
"Well, SpongeBob, take a gander at this,"
Sandy announced, leaping over to a rock the size of SpongeBob's pineapple home in Bikini Bottom. Closing her eyes, Sandy summoned up all of her inner strength and without a sound gave the massive boulder a single karate chop. All was still. Then the rock began to vibrate, sending ripples through the water. The rock continued to shake, finally exploding into a million tiny pieces that scattered in all directions. A stray pebble bounced off SpongeBob's forehead. "Ooh," he said, dumbfounded at the little squirrel's amazing display of karate.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books,
Use the link in the video description.